They wouldn't let us say goodbye. They didn't even let me kiss her.
Lazaro and Diana are asylum seekers fleeing hardships they endured in Cuba. For their safety, PBS NewsHour has agreed to keep their names private and faces obscured. When the couple reached the U.S.-Mexico border in June 2019, only Diana, who was pregnant at the time, was allowed to enter.
I almost died that day. Just imagine, I was headed for this country alone, and Lazaro, according to them at the time, had been deported, and I was pregnant.
Lazaro had been sent back to Juarez, Mexico, under the Trump administration's Migrant Protection Protocols policy, more commonly known as the Remain in Mexico program. The immigration policy forced Lazaro and thousands of others to wait in Mexico for his asylum case to be processed.
Those were very difficult hours because she didn't know what they would do to me, and I didn't know what they were going to do to her. They didn't let us talk to each other at any point.
Nearly a year and a half has passed since the couple has seen each other.
My daughter was born, and I haven't been able to meet her. I'm dying to hold her, to give her a kiss. But for now, it's only through photos or video calls.
While awaiting a decision on his case, Lazaro secured a job at a funeral home that allowed him to rent a shared apartment in Juarez. But not all asylum seekers are as fortunate.
In Juarez, we believe that roughly 10 to 15% of the people are living in shelters, which are often incredibly difficult conditions.
Taylor Levy, an immigration attorney working with asylum seekers on the U.S.-Mexico border, has witnessed many of the living conditions herself. While shelters are often incredibly difficult conditions, she says conditions for rented living spaces are often more dangerous.
Lots of times these apartments are basically tenements. They're slums. They're buildings where nobody else would be willing to rent them, and that's why they've been rented out to migrants.
Nearly 70,000 asylum seekers were returned to Mexico under the Migrant Protection Protocol's policy between January 2019 and when President Biden suspended the program on his first day in office. During that time, violence and poor living conditions south of the border made it difficult for individuals to find lawyers or even receive reliable communication about their cases.
We know that almost none of them won their cases. We know that I believe around 40,000 of those people were deported in absentia, so they were deported for not going to their court case.
But in February, the Biden administration offered relief for the 25,000 asylum seekers who currently have active cases. Under the first phase of rolling back the Remain in Mexico policy, the administration will allow those individuals to enter the U.S. while their cases work through immigration courts. But the change will be slow going. Only three ports of entry will process up to 300 people a day at best, and it will not help those whose cases have already been denied or closed. For now, Lazaro and Diana remain separated and uncertain of their future.
What we have planned for the future is nothing out of this world. A home, a stable family, and good financial security. Because that's what we'll be working for. And to be able to raise our daughter in the best way possible.
And with an active case and a lawyer's help, Lazaro has hope that they will soon be reunited. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Dima Zane.